storm trooper swarm. The Death Star's more than the devilish dawn. It's when evil and the force manifest their form. It's no good without bad and no night without one. It's relativity, valid stability. It's creativity, talent.
Shit right here, nigga. This shit right here, nigga. This shit right, this shit right here, nigga, nigga. Right here.
Thanks for checking out my little instructional video here. So the first part we're going to deal with on our way to making some custom GIF images is we'll just do a simple animation. I put a note in the video. You should have downloaded GIF Cam, which is this icon here. The link is in the description. So after we've done editing our pieces here, we can go straight to putting the GIF itself together. So these are the three pieces I've chosen for this first simple animation. So let's go ahead and get into it, and I'll explain further as we go. This is iPicky.com, and this site here will allow you to do some simple animations, edit pictures, and the other cool thing is it allows you to store them on the website here, so you don't have to be taking up, you know, your own computer's memory. Let me go to the start page here. Alright, so this is what you'll come to when you first start out. Just go and click start editing. And, it's gonna be best for you to just register, it's free. So use your email address to register. And when you first come in, you'll see a little button right here. It'll say allow local storage, something about storage. You want to go and click that and enable it, and that's going to allow you to store your pictures here. But let's go ahead and start real quick. So as I noted before, you want to make sure every single piece, every image you're going to use, since we're starting off with pictures, is the same exact size. And so for that, you can use this simple resize piece here. And you'll find that if you're taking a couple, you're taking from different pictures, and they're different sizes, you won't always be able to make them the same size using this, because it can. So here you'll see constrained proportions. So what that does is it limits it to a certain height and width ratio. So to make it easy on ourselves, we can always just do this. So for this, I'll just choose random width. Don't want to make it too big, because like we also, like we noted before, if it's too big, we're going to have trouble moving it. So let's do width. Go over here. We need a little bit wider. Alright, so 277 times 377, that's going to be the width and height I'm going to use for all of my pieces. Make sure you remember that point, so that way when you make our GIF, it's nice and clean transition. So we'll apply that, and I'll do some other small things to it. I like to do this HDR thing, and it gives it a cool effect. So that was one small animation piece I did to it. You can choose any of these if you'd like. But when I make my things, I like to make them real synchronized. So I like to have every single piece have the same effect. So let's see what this does. No. Alright, I'll just stick with that for now. So now you're going to save it to your desktop. Let's do piece one. Uploaded all my pieces, so I'll go here. Remember, we said same size. Times 377 is what I chose. And I used this before. I faded my theme. Alright, so there's piece two. Third and final piece. Same process. Just gonna, you don't have to repeat your animations or your little tweaks, but it was a good ghost. Alright, so I'll keep that. Now I've got all three of my pieces. Now we'll go to GIF cam here. Alright, so the easiest way to do this is whatever photo editor or photo viewer you use, just go ahead and I use the simple Windows photo viewer. So I right click and I go to preview. So now we got the GIF cam here. This black box and outline you see, that's going to be the area that it captures, so you want to make sure your pictures all fit in there.